What up, everybody? Welcome back to the Garden State Hip Hop Hour. We're back at Sloppy Vinyl Studios. Today with me, I got the one, the only, repping 1012.
You know what's going on. Nate Taylorr in the buildings, Central Jersey. You know how we move.
Wait, what is that? Reek, right?
Oh, yeah, it's Reek Havoc.
Is that like a friend? Is that someone you know? You say that a lot of your...
That's Reek Havoc's basically like my friend group when we were younger, and we just wreaked havoc. So, like, I just put it in my songs, basically, to always remember where I come from, basically.
Wait, oh, wreaked instead of wrecked.
Yeah, it's not, yeah, a lot of people keep thinking it's, like, it's wreck, or it's, like, reek. Nah, it's reek. It's like a reek type of shit.
You gotta have, like, a little sound to it.
Yeah, basically, you gotta have a little aggression to it. I ain't saying reek. Like, that's, like, reek. I ain't doing that.
And we just had a whole conversation. You remember Central Jersey, not South Jersey, not North Jersey.
Not
you
South.
You said Central Jersey is the real Jersey.
Yeah, we got a heart of Jersey. Where's their heart? In the middle, right? So we get a heart of Jersey.
What about like the west of Jersey?
What's West Jersey? I'm just saying, like, I am not. Where's the camera? Where am I looking at? Which one? I don't even know. But basically, I am not.
Let's look at the middle one.
I'm not from New York. I am not from Philly. I'm not from Toronto. I am not from London, Germany. I am from New Jersey, Central Jersey, 732 Freehold. Yes, that's where I'm from.
But you got a big fan base in Toronto and Canada, don't you?
I love y'all. I fucking love y'all. My fans are like family. They're not really like, they're the best support system ever. Like, they're always showing me love, always telling me like things that I want to hear and also need to hear. You know, it also expands my sound and where I want to go, like, in the future, because, like, they like my rugged, like, rough sound. I never have to be on some, like, fake shit with them. Usually, like, my fans are, like little pieces of me in a way, because they relate to what I got going on in my life.
I dig it. You have, like, a name for them? Like, you know, like, people have, like, different names for their fan bases?
I haven't got to that point yet. I would love for one of my fans to make a fan page or a name. I've gotten people saying the 1012 gang to me before. I've gotten King Taylorr before, which is not like that was kind of fire.
King Taylorr?
I've gotten King.
But for our fan base?
No. They started calling me King Taylorr before, and it was dope. I like that. But I'm not a king, but I am a king. You feel me? I got a kingdom. Kingdom be fire.
Because you King Taylorr, you need the kingdom.
King Taylorr, you know, it's good.
Like, yo, imagine starting off all your interviews like that. Yo, it's King Taylorr.
King Taylorr, a.k.a. Lil Note, a.k.a. Nate Taylorr. Lil Note's my, like,
King of Jersey?
Oh, whew. If y'all feel that way, listen. I know I'm not going live, bro. Like, no. Y'all can't really like mess with me, like, in a way, because like the only way I'm gonna say this, because like I'm not trying to rush it, but like I create everything that I started in the beginning with my team. Like, I made beats first. I never went on YouTube, unlike you fake rappers.
Damn.
I made
what
a
was
lot
that
of,
towards.
No, like, I'm just saying, like, I don't.
That was pretty aggressive right there.
No, because I never had to go on a YouTube beat. And, like, everything started from in-house, from the ground up. Nobody gave us handouts. We did this on our own. Another thing I would just say, like, we write our own things. We don't need ghostwriters over here. I never got a co-sign from nobody in this area like that. We had to get it on our own. And I just kept consistent at it. I fuck everybody I mess with, like, 07, I fuck with 070. Competition. Fuck with Mir Fontaine. Like, people that really show me love out here like that is basically those two camps from South Jersey and North Jersey. So that's what I love out there.
Where's that Central Jersey love? That's what you're repping so hard for.
I love my city.
Like, I'm saying, where's like the artists from Central Jersey? They ain't showing you love?
No, they show me love. It just like gets to a point like I really don't like collaborating with people that I feel that aren't on my level. Like, this, like, type of stuff. I don't really feel like I never needed features. You never see no Nate Taylorr featuring people like that. It's just Nate. Just me. I rap, I sing, I mix myself, I master myself. You know, everybody I be working with is thorough, like, you know, Chase the Money, Business Boy,
Norman Perry,
yeah. Mir Fontaine, Oxen O'Fee. You know, you got Simon Mass Appeal with Nas and everything. I can go down a list. I mess with people, and like, I always make like what I got going on, it always sounds good.
Nah, yeah, and you're Cian P, right? That's Cian P, did I say it right?
Cian. You know, Cian? When I first,
like, it's like Cian.
Yo, when I first met him, I thought it was Cian. Like, I thought his name was Cian P. But he's from Canada, and, you know, we never even met. No.
But that's what I'm saying, because I know last time we talked, you said you have a fan base out there. You want to go out there. One of your main producers you work with is him, and he's from out there. Mm-hmm. Your sound has, like, The Weeknd, Tory.
Yeah.
I mean, so, like, where did, like, Do you just love Canada? Like, what's up?
Nah, Canada, well, obviously, I've got influence. Like, my influences, let me even get there. My influences are The Weeknd, Tory Lanez, Drake, Chris Brown, Travis Scott, Thug, and you want to go back and some, you want to throw some haymakers from the back in the day, Sean Paul. Mm. That's that.
Give me the light.
Man to die. That's my guy, bro. T-Pain, Lil Wayne. I can go down a list. J. Cole.
At this point, you just named everybody.
Nah, because they all really had, they really, because you really can't put a genre on what I do. Like, I be doing a lot of stuff. I get real songs and I get, you know, fun party songs, you know?
Life of the party.
Life of the party. Shout out to, I don't know who that girl was that put, but yeah, shout out.
Yeah. I feel like anyone I show like your music for the most part, 99% of them like really fuck with it, so.
Because you fuck with my music, that means you cool as hell. Like, you gotta be cool as hell. If you don't like my music, it's very strange when you don't like my music.
Yeah.
It's very is. Like, it's like, I'm not even trying to be that type of guy right now, but like, it's really very strange you don't like my music, because then it's like, I don't think you like music. I think you just like bubblegum shit and like just whack shit.
So you feel like your music just has like more of a mass appeal?
Oh, 100%. Like, really 100%. This is, like, I don't want to be this guy, but I'm very passionate when it comes to my music. And when I put it out, usually people, feel me. In the beginning, there was people that didn't understand, they didn't feel me at all. So I had to get into real vibes and had to get into things that actually was, you know, that could connect to people. Because I used to make very slow music. I used to make songs that weren't, they were good songs, but they weren't like you're gonna, you know, replay value to it. So I had to get a little oomph in my step and stuff to get my pen game better, production better, all the other stuff like that.
What was that turning point? Like, how did you turn that corner?
It was 2018, because I had a very rough year 2018. I didn't get, you know, there was points in my life there, like I was feeling down. My personal life wasn't really going that well. My music was like kind of, I wasn't dropping as much music I used to. Like, well, not even ever. I dropped a few songs here and there. And then, like, I started, this in 2018, I was messing with 070. Like, I was working with the competition, shout out to Razzy, Sebastian, Ether. They took me into a way to, you know, help me develop my sound to be like, all right, you dope artist. So I started really messing with them. I had a couple songs with them. And it was great. Learning experience to actually, you know, get to it. Don't be just making a song a day, because a lot of artists aren't consistent. They told me to keep consistent, always try to put out the best product. Don't hesitate, just whatever makes you feel good, just drop it. But I learned that from them hanging out in that camp. And it's just like the end of 2018, I dropped a project. It was called 4 for 1. And it wasn't like it was a bad project. It just wasn't like, I got what I needed to get from it. I got it from people telling me, like, the feedback I got from it, it was, like, it was cool, but it was done after, like, it was, like, done in, like, a week. No one really mentioned it, only except one song, and that was it. And that's what I produced with Billy, my bad, B-Hall. It was B-Hall from 0702. So, yeah, it was a really learning experience to understand that, you know, I had to get better. Because a lot of artists get shit fucked up saying, like, oh, niggas ain't fucking with me. Oh, they ain't messing with me, yada, yada. But, bro, they're not messing with you because you're not good enough.
Yeah.
Like, that's basically it. Like, it's just people take a lot of that, like, to heart when people aren't messing with them. It's like, all right, be doper.
Nah, fact. But now you feel like you developed a sound that's pretty unique to the state. Like, I know the state doesn't really have a sound itself, but you feel you sound.
Do you think I have a New Jersey sound?
No, but I don't think there's really, like, necessarily an official sound out here, but I do feel you sound very different from the rest still.
Oh, yeah. Despite that. Because, bro, I don't hop on waves. We are the wave. Like, 10-12 is that. Like, we really are like that. Like, you can't even, it's just two people. Like, it's me and Foreign. There's nobody else that really
running can be it, right?
Running it.
Because you guys have artists underneath you.
Oh, 100%. Nobody's underneath anybody. Everybody's their own entity on the team. Okay. You know, 7 Late Nights. He's coming up. He's about to drop his new song. There's a couple other artists, you know, that are dropping. And everybody has their own way. Everybody moves in their own time. No one's on 10-12. We develop artists. We don't let them do, you know, dumb shit. But at the same time, we let them learn, you know, all right, this is what you got to do. Like, Foreign's, like, he be coaching people. They understand. There's other artists that work with us, too.
Yeah.
That are not 10-12, but they work with us.
Yeah, yeah.
That understand.
How you decide who can join 10-12, though? Like, you said 7 Late Nights, right? So, do you go out and find artists, or is it just having to be friends around?
It has to be, like, to be the part of 10-12, you have to have the work ethic like 10-12.
Mm.
You need to be able to, you know, get to it. You can't just be around. You have to actually work hard. Because no one helped us to get where we're at. So, like, if you really want something, go get something and bring it back to the team.
Facts. And let's talk about the song that you keep saying is going to change your life, right? Talk to me.
Talk to me.
Yeah, every time just you talk to me, it goes baby. Crazy, right?
Why you never listen to me, so impatient? Why you always looking at me like you hate me? Talk to me, baby.
You know, I really do
it's
sing.
Infectious.
I'm just saying, like, I really do this. Like, I'm not one of these little auto-tune artists either. I can really do this. I'm sorry. If you get hurt from this, it's just...
Yeah, you came out of aggressive tips tonight. What you guys do before you came here? What you going for and do?
Oh, nothing.
you guys in the car like, yo, we just going to go up there and start talking about everything. Put people in line.
I just be talking. Because it's like...
Talk to me.
Yeah, because it just speaks for itself. Like, I don't know what it's at right now, but...
But what is it about that song that you feel is going to change your life?
Everybody likes the song. Like, everybody likes... I don't like the song.
Why you don't like the song?
Well, I like the song. I made it. It's like one of my kids, but like one of the kids, like, you know, there's like this little troublemaker, but
yeah.
It's just,
you're supposed to,
I don't got a kid though. So yeah, to my other future kid, bro, I'm just joking. I love you.
So then what's your favorite song of yours then?
My favorite song on the project?
Just period.
Period I ever made.
Talk to Me is off Life. No, it's not off Life.
It's on Life's a Luxury. It's on Luxury too.
Oh, okay.
The song that I like, my favorite song on the project, it has to be Reasons. Reasons is my favorite song because it's like, you feel me, like I'm really saying this shit, like.
No, I like Enemy, I like Life of the Party, Damage, obviously.
Damage is a really, really great song. That's a great song. I love Damage. Like, Damage is like when this is where I separate myself from other people, because you can always do these rap songs, you know what you would sing, but after they can't hit notes like me. And the production, shout out to Cian, is amazing. So like, it just separated me, because me and Keen kind of crafted our sound together. That's why I even got my cadence. I got all a lot of stuff like that. So my voice and tone works a lot of his production. But then I feel like Damage is just gonna creep up on people low key. And I'm gonna get that in a movie. Like, I'm gonna get it in a TV show and everything. Mm. It's gonna be one of those Netflix. I manifest over here. I'm sorry if I speak too much.
Nah, you're good. You told me you're gonna have a song with The Weeknd by next year.
100%.
Now you're gonna be in a movie.
XO12.
Huh? XO12. That shit hard, though. I fuck with that.
I'm sorry, XO12 is in the way. Like, and when you look back in this, and when I'm standing next to Abel or Nav or anybody, I'm just please clip this. Put it right next to him.
like, what would a song with you and The Weeknd sound like? Which version of The Weeknd? Because, you know, he has different errors, he has different sounds.
Like, I'd bring the best Weeknd out. Like, literally. He's really the
trilogy Weeknd.
I'd bring out, no, nah, like.
Beauty Behind the Madness Weeknd.
No, I'd bring out, like, because he's a pop god. Like, he's a pop star. Like, he's really a megastar. Like, that type of shit. But like, I want him to get more like on his often the, like, I want him to get his rugged shit back again. But that's when he was like, you know, he's literally the megastar. He can do what he wants. But enough about Abel. But we gonna fuck with each other soon. Just hit my line, cuz did look at my IG too. Just throwing that out there. I'm not lying. Like, I'm not lying. There's no need to lie.
So you're keeping the album around. Like, a lot of artists sometimes just drop the project, especially like in Jersey, they drop the project, maybe like play with it for like a month, and then already start working on the next, you know, album or the next set of music.
I'm gonna surprise y'all at the end of the year. I'm gonna surprise y'all.
Were you surprised at the numbers this album did, or were you expecting it?
Always. I always expect better. Like, I was definitely like excited to see the over the million our first week. We had over a million first week, Spotify. Mm.
Well, I need like a little sound effect.
No, I'm just saying, like fuck with me. I want to work with mad Jersey artists, man. Like, I want to work with people, but that no one wants to reach out. I don't get it. Like, I'm really nice. Like, do I need to what I gotta do?
Like, reach out.
No, trust me. There's artists that know I reached out. You know, there's artists that I've definitely reached out to, but
they like doing it red or
no? They didn't leave. Man, niggas ain't leave me on red, bro. I'm just saying, like, motherfuckers is just like, they just, you know how Jersey artists are?
No, I don't. I'm not a Jersey artist. Tell me.
Oh, you're going to get me in trouble.
I'm not an artist. I can't tell you how, I can tell you how, like, a Jersey blogger is.
There's
like...
definitely artists that are nice as shit. There's a lot of dope Jersey artists, but when I hit artists up, it's like, it's ego. It's everybody gets egos.
Who you hit up?
Ah, you gonna throw some names out.
I don't know, like, I can.
They know who they are. So, like, there's artists that, like, I've definitely hit up in the past and try a little bro me type shit. Mm. But they're nowhere to be found now. Damn. Like, they're just here, being around. They be in LA, you know, take the little pictures, the rented cars.
But now if they reach back out to you, would you just put it underneath the rug and work with them? Or would you hold it up to them? You attack them?
Yeah.
Okay.
I attack y'all. because you didn't.
You have like a little list somewhere, like, nah, this person reaches out.
Bro, I got him flagged in my DM. Damn. I remember a lot of things. There's people. That's why I fuck with Norman Perry from Connecticut. Like, me and Bro, I hit Bro up last year trying to work, bro. But he kept it real with me, and I said, I bet I'm gonna hit you next time. I'd rather have.
What he said to you, like, you weren't at like a level yet?
It was not even at a level. It just to a point, like, it just like there was a thing I didn't want to do to do it, and I'm just like, yo, I'm like. I waited another year and I came back to him. Bro just hopped on the song. And I said, bro, at the video, I was like, yo, year round, we're gonna be working right now, buddy. Like, you feel me? Like, yeah, I'm one of the type of people, bro. Like, if you really real with me, because I'm loyal, like, I'm a loyal person when it comes to this game. Like, Everybody I've worked with is 5+, 10+ years around me. I've known these people. And, like, with me and Cian, I worked with Cian for 2.5 years. Now, see where we at, 2 years. When I first started with him, I had 2K monthly plays on Spotify and everything like that. And then 2 years now later, we hit over 1 million on our executive produced album. And then I have over 100K with listeners. Like, this is all.
Talk to me, got like 360.
About to hit 1 million before this year's over. Quote me.
700,000 in 2 months? Because I think I actually just looked at it before we got here. I think
the first.
Are you just talking about on Spotify only, or are you talking about just in total general?
Oh, you want to talk about Spotify. This is only on Spotify, baby.
No, that's what I was talking about. It's at 363,000.
Total record on all platforms is over definitely 1 million.
Damn. For Talk to Me or the whole project?
No, Talk to Me itself.
Damn.
Like, you go on Apple Music, go on YouTube.
Like, how did that day feel when you saw it like cross that number, that million mark? Did you celebrate? Did you pop a bottle?
Hell yeah, I took mad shots of tequila. Yo, I was in that bitch teed. Bro, that ass. Like, I was having a great time. I was like, these are achievements that, you know, people always gotta forget. Like, they always forget, like, enjoy the moment.
Yeah.
Like, people always are so, like, and I'm a person, I always wanna keep going and going and going. But then I realized, like, yo, I really gotta sit back and enjoy what the fuck I just did. Like, what the fuck? I just did this? What the fuck? Yo, like, I was hanging out with, like, I think, did I link up with Foreign? Did I link up with you? I linked up with Raul. Oh, crack. I linked up with, like, Terrell. I linked up all my homies. We were just out just tea. Like, what? I was gassed. I really wish, you know, it was outside. If we were outside.
Different.
If we were outside.
But you dropped the project in the midst of the pandemic.
Yeah, that was
it. So I know you had to probably just, like. Because were you planning the drop, or was it just kind of like, let me release it?
Nah, well, I changed everything, the whole idea from when we got in the pandemic to, like, it was going to be called Repercussions, the tape, and then, like, all the shit was going on. I was gonna drop it in actually April and May, but since all that happened, I kind of changed the whole concept to the album, and I was, you know, let me just, the only original song that I had to change on there that was, I think it was Life of the Party.
Like, wait, what do you mean?
Like, it was, there were other songs for Repercussion, I just scrapped all of them, and I made a new album.
Damn.
Yeah, basically. It was just like,
let me just start the shit all over.
Yeah, let me start it over, because life's a real luxury. People, the whole concept for life's a luxury is basically, you know, when we've seen all that, like, the mess up happened to everybody getting killed, George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, and everything like that, people don't understand that you got to appreciate every minute and moment you have with your loved ones and understand that everything is not. Don't be taking anything for granted at all. Like, there's no point of doing that. Like, so when this happened, I was spending time with my mother a lot. I was spending time with my friends I haven't seen in a while. Wearing, like, got on my health shit. I started cooking. I started doing working. Like, I really appreciated how life's really a luxury. People get caught up in the partying. People get caught up in the Instagram. People get caught up in a lot of little things that really don't matter. You lose my phone, like, it's gone today. Like, I still am me. I'm still get to be around people I care about.
Yeah.
So, like, and I want to be able to look back and be like, I'm around my loved ones, everything. If I go today, man, I don't regret shit. Basically, that's what life's a luxury is to me. So my life's a luxury is be able to live my truth, live what I want to do. And nobody's, you know, can tell me shit.
And now it's like just even trying to figure out how to navigate forward musically, because you can't really do the tours, you can't do the shows. I'm sure certain things that you can't.
But this is the thing. This is like the biggest I've ever been. Like, a lot of people make excuses. Over at 10 Soul, we don't make excuses. We literally just adapt.
So, like, what was the biggest thing you guys changed, though, to make it work during this time?
Change our game plan.
So what was the game plan?
The game plan is just move. Just keep moving. Nah, like, just keep moving. Nah, consistency. I'm very consistent. I'm very consistent in what I do. And if something doesn't work, I'm going to do something else. And persistent. I hit up everybody I work with, bro, when it came down to Chase, when it came down to, what is it, to Business Boy, when it came down to the competition, like, I don't do no little over people. Even Keen got songs with Lil Peep. Night Lavelle, Bi-Fi Funeral. We got songs. I'm saying I don't work with Buddy and nobody that's a nobody.
Nah, yeah, I won't say the name I respect for you, but didn't like some huge artist take a beat from somebody or take a beat, or you were supposed to have a beat that was taken.
So let's just get this straight.
I'm not gonna say the name if you want to.
We can say the name. Nah, I ain't gonna say the name. I'm like, I ain't trying to get in trouble. It's not.
But like, it just shows the level of the producers, you know what I'm saying, that you're working with, where their beats are going to.
Bro, that's what I'm saying. Like, over here at 10-12, like this right here, over here at 10-12, bro, you're gonna see this everywhere, bro. It's not a little thing. We really are like a huge entity. And when we get up, when we have to be at it, you're gonna see it. And I want everybody to Jersey to really understand, like, I'm really repping for us right now. Like, it's every time I be saying, so you hear my music, it's 10-12, you hear Reek, you hear Jersey. Like, I'm rep. No, there, nobody's gonna take this. Like, I'm gonna rep Jersey. There's artists in Jersey that don't do this, that always wanna, they wanna hide where they from. I'm not going to hide where we're from, because we have Lauryn Hill out here. Like, bro, like, what?
You have John Mez out here.
Bro, we have like Frank Sinatra. We have all like the people, like, we got mad people that are legendary out. Bruce Springsteen, white ass. Uh oh.
My first time learning white people are from Jersey.
Yo, like. Yeah, you didn't know that?
Wow.
Oh, yeah, where are you from? Freehold. Where are you from? By the way, just saying, like.
Wow. I thought I was in a room full of people that like music and just in this music industry. Then we got even the background, didn't you know?
Yeah, bro, I'm a nerd with this shit. Like, I really study. Like, and if y'all got offended to that, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. It just came out.
You definitely got artists. Russ is from Jersey, right?
Yeah, he don't want to claim it like that, but he's from Jersey.
Coil Ray.
Yeah.
So when you go to the studio, like, what are some, like, what is your session like in the studio? Do you have, like, a ton of people? Do you have certain things you need to bring in?
I am by myself.
Oh, you go in there just solo?
Yeah, I do it in my house.
Oh, you record all your music in your house?
Yeah, I don't waste money on studio time.
Is there going to be a 10-12 studio coming? Are you guys,
like, we have a 10-12 studio. If you want to come, hit up Foreign. He got you.
Is this your house?
No, it's a studio.
Oh, okay. What else you guys got? Because I know you guys, you know, have artists, you're a label. I know you guys were doing shows or planning to do shows earlier in the year.
We have a tour coming. The tour's coming in 2021. It was supposed to come this year, but, you know, this shit happened. I was going to go overseas with Germany, London, Toronto, all the other places, you know. But it's going to be an overseas tour. Then we're going to come back to the States.
You got to keep building that fan base.
Oh, yeah. I would love to. Oh, shit. I would love to, you know, see all my fans in every area because it's just like, when I interact with all my fans, so like when we speak, it's like I always ask them, like, where are you from? What's your favorite song? Most of them has always talked to me, reasons, situations sometimes. It's just like, and they always tell me, so it's like kind of dope that, you know, I don't ever want to be to a point when I get to a point that they can't feel they can reach out. Because a couple fans reached out to me and helped them like get through some stuff with certain songs because they were going through it. Because I have like 17, 16-year-old people that are like kind of like, you know, going through that time in their life. They want to learn themselves. So like some person was stressing in my DM about some stuff. And I was like, yo, it's okay. How old are you? They're like, I'm 14. I was like, you're 14. Like, you literally have so much life ahead of you. Don't let no relationship fuck you up like that.
But in that moment, in that moment, though, it feels like everything.
Oh, it's shit. That's the reason why I even started singing. Shit.
So it's Talk to Me About Somebody?
No.
Talk to Me About Somebody?
So. All my music is real events. I don't lie. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay.
I don't lie.
I know, because you're a songcrafter. You create music. Sometimes you could just be writing about in general. I didn't know if it was necessarily about someone specific.
Mostly, when you hear any of my, like, my... Right, Talk to Me is about, you know, an individual that was, you know, they didn't want to have open communication. And everything is literally just talk to me. Like, stop wasting time. Just get to the point. Like, we can talk this out. But some people don't want to hear it, you know, when they get all type of Philly type of way about stuff, you know. But also, you know, it was a wrong vibe at the time. It was good at the moment, but, you know, now it's, you know, moved past that.
Our communication is fucking...
Communication is very...
Like, no matter what the relationship is.
What I learned is, when making music, I learn a lot about people. Like, why you guys are like, what music you want to listen to. A lot of people listen to rap music because you want to feel like hype. You want to feel like that him. You want to feel like invincible. It's like Pop Smoke was going so well because he makes you feel invisible. And like you got the party. That's how you're feeling this. But a lot of people, you know, people like Talk to Me. In reality, y'all feel that because you've been through that. So I learn a lot about myself during this process. I learned a lot about females. I learned a lot about even males, because, like, yo, me or we or everybody wants to put out this, like, this tough outer, you know, outer type of skin type of stuff. In reality, like, y'all reason why Drake's number one because you guys are vulnerable as fuck, right? like you people don't understand that you can't be so hard. Everybody's so hard. Like, just be cool. It's okay to be all right. Like, you can be vulnerable and still be, like, you know, masculine, bro.
Now you're right, because, you know, I be feeling so much better about shit, because I'm like, damn, if someone's playing out Drake, then if I got played out, it's cool.
You know how many people,
you
know,
like, yo, if Drake can get played out, if Drake can get blocked, if Drake, you know what I'm saying?
No, but bro, Drake's Drake, but, like, at the end of the day, he's still human.
Like, nah, that's what I'm saying, though. Yeah. Someone, like, at that level, you're saying someone who's looked up globally like that can be played out, then, hey, it happens.
Well, I don't think, well, played out in a way, what you mean?
I don't know, because he be singing about his heartbreak and shit.
Well, you know? But that's, well, that, listen, that's his truth. Like, Kanye was talking about his stuff, when he was talking about Jesus Walks, you feel me? Like, everybody's, like, different. You know, everybody wanted to be there too, but I'm saying, you'll never hear me on, like, a drill type beat unless I'm with an artist that actually doesn't come from that type of, like, that sound. Yeah. Like, I'll never, when the, like, you know, the dance hall wave was going on, I never hopped on that type of wave like that. I never, you know, when, like, the Cali type wave was going on, I never really went on those type either. It's just, like, I know what's going to be, because, you know, if you're going to do stuff like that, you got to make sure that it matches your sound, because then you'll get trapped in the era. There's certain artists that are stuck in an era now that they can't really hop out of, because that's where you got your bread and butter from like a sound that really wasn't yours. It was just a hot at the moment.
Nah, yeah, I dig it. So then, like, are you gonna keep the same sound for the next album? Or are you planning on switching it up?
I always learn from artists. Like, I learn from the greats. Like, every great artist changes their sound every year, or every type of characteristic. Like, Jay-Z he was always preaching the same type of content, but he was never the same in every project. You will never get Reasonable Doubt ever again. But he also has some misses with Kingdom Come. Like, so, like, you're going to have those things like that. And, like, Drake evolved every album. Kendrick evolved every album. You gotta get better as a person. And if you're the same, and you're, that means you're stagnant. Like, I never want to. Like, I'm sorry I'm doing this again, but, like, I just don't just because it worked. Like, what I do is, like, if it works, I work, but enhance it. Make it bigger than the last thing you did. Yeah. Every single time. But don't recreate the same thing, because you'll never actually ever recreate the same thing. It's like making a sandwich. You can't make the same sandwich.
Yeah, nah, but I mean, like, but I know it's got to be somewhat nervous, because, like, damn, you just had all this success, and to try to switch it up, and you don't know if it's going to hit or miss, you know?
I'll play you some shit when this is over. yo, this, though, like, no, like, look for him, bro. We are not playing.
He's had the same face the whole time.
Because of some shit, bro.
You said, look at him, I thought, like, maybe, like, he had an excited face.
you know what it is, bro. Like, oh, like, I just understand, like, it's like, I'm never, if you get to a point and you feel like you can't recreate something again, like, oh, I'll never do this again, that means you're not really an artist.
Yeah.
You're just like a little puppet. They gotta teach you how to do stuff. Like, I don't need song. Like, they gotta be like, come on, do this, sing it like that. Like, no, bro, I don't need to do that.
What about when you make the videos for these songs? Are you, like, pushing the creative direction? Do you leave that in the hands of your team?
Me, all team, all in-house. Everything we do is in-house. Nothing is, no one has to do, like, no one has to, like, kind of, like, reach out to anybody. If we do reach out to people, I would always love to work with people. I love working with creatives. Creatives are the best. Like, we run this shit. But, like, everybody has to be open ears. Everybody has to understand, like, no egos, put that shit to the side. If we're on the same team, we are on the same team. Do not be wasting time and trying to argue with me when we want the same goals. That just makes no sense. So, like, everybody, like, when we work together, like, all right, when I got Foreign over here, then I got Grant shooting, but then Foreign's looking at the angle, that looks good. All right, where Trey, can he get, like, the picture of me on the side? Then also, like, yo, even the models, like, what would like you to, you know, you want to stand over here a little bit? Everybody can put their two cents. No one's, like, you know, you can always say something if it's going to add towards something.
Now, yeah, how were you able to find all these people who are able to just make you pretty much the centerpiece? Not necessarily the centerpiece, but in that moment, you know, they understand it's about you. I feel like a lot of artists have problems finding, like, the people surround them, like, that know the focus is on the artist, not on them.
Well, that's why it's, like, only the same. It's literally just me and Foreign. Like, it's just, like, I also, you know, I got a lot of help from he's a Jersey, entity. You know, I keep saying entity, but, like, I'm gonna say, like, low-key, he a go-to me. Mike Hardy.
Okay.
Yeah, he gave me a lot of guidance in the beginning of my, I came with, like, you know, Mike Gipp, Feel Good Finesse, you feel me? I was over there. And, like, we were just, like, they taught me type of pretty much, like, yo, come on, like, you gotta be always ahead 10 times, you know, step of the game type of stuff. So, like, Mike got me the first person to even put my music on TuneCore and shit.
Oh, really?
He was the first person.
No, he's consistent, right? He was chasing Russ down for like 2 years.
And look at that, manifestation, bro. That's what I'm saying. Like, and I've seen it. Like, I've seen it. So it's
Is he from Freehold too?
Nah, he's not from Freehold. I don't know, actually. I don't want to throw out where he's from. I think it's Old Bridge. I think it's Old. No, it's not. Oh, okay. Don't even do it.
Oh, okay, no, I didn't know how you guys crossed paths.
New Brunswick, my bad. Okay. He lives in New Brunswick. I don't know. Like, I think he's from New Brunswick. Yeah, I think I'm not.
Okay, no, I just didn't know if you guys, that's how you guys crossed paths, was from the
same. Nah, boy, I met him when I was recording with Mike Gipp.
Oh, okay.
Mike Gipp's a legend. Mm. Like, he's a Jersey Club legend. Like, there's
you went to Jersey Club like that?
I started off with Team Reckless, their Jersey Club.
Oh, okay, okay.
That was the first producer, like CVG. He helped me, like, get my first song out there. And he works with like 4B from Jersey.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
You see, a lot of Jersey ties here. You feel me?
So I got you about to drop another Jersey Club song this year? You coming with that?
I did do a Jersey Club song this year. Yeah. It's on his album.
Oh,
his
EP. Okay. I didn't catch his album.
It's called Don't Care. Mm-hmm. So like I just got an MI in him, you know, the collab EP.
You're becoming an entity.
Oh, I know.
Oh, let's see that.
Like you strong as hell. Damn. Oh, yo. Damn. Nah, we got it. You feel me? I got it. Oh, don't.
There you go.
Yo, so like, nah, I'm enjoying this right now though. Like I'm in my moment and like I'm really soaking this in. Like there's nothing nobody really can tell me shit right now. Like everything I feel is like I earned. Nobody like there's a lot of people like really doubted, like us in general, to make things happen, and now I'm hanging out with real official people, like every single.
What do they doubt though? The talent, your ability to push music, like which part of it?
I feel like there's people that, you know,
they just didn't want to see you shine.
No, I don't know. I just feel like people that when people want to see someone else fail, that means you're putting a lot of energy into someone that, you know, didn't do anything towards you, like to you. You're investing so much negative energy on somebody telling me like, I hope, man, fuck that. He ain't sweet like that. Like, oh, bro. Go better yourself, bro. Like, I ain't really with the... That's why I really stay out the way. Like, I'm barely, if it's not music, or I'm out doing business, or inspire and getting inspiration for something, I'm not doing it.
Wait, so what you do, like, what's a daily day for Nate Taylor?
A day-to-day Nate Taylor, as of right now, is going to New York every freaking day. Like, it's...
What's in New York? Studios or...
Inspiration.
Yeah.
Inspiration. Shout out to my man Cavalli. Feels me?
You gotta get inspired by Jersey. What you mean?
I do get inspired by Jersey, but like, I do get inspired by Jersey. I'm still repping Jersey. I'm just, you know, like I just take my trips to New York. Like New York to me is like the wave right now. Like to just be around, it's the energy.
Nah, I thought you was the wave.
I am the wave.
And I thought you was in Jersey.
I'm in Jersey.
So how is New York the wave?
Because you talking to us? So you call me, yo. What time is he on right now, yo? he caught me. But no, I'm just saying. Like it's like where I'm from is what is it? Central Jersey.
He said what?
Where I'm from is Central Jersey. But like when I get into like a bag, I want new inspiration. When I make music, like my new inspiration music is when like I go out and experience new things, going to areas like that. Like I went to Atlanta the other day.
The other day?
A couple weeks ago.
Oh, okay, dumb.
We went to Atlanta a couple weeks ago, and like I came back and I made great music, cause I always record in Jersey.
But the inspiration was in Atlanta.
Always, yeah.
Oh, okay, like, is that how you linked up with your new team, or not your new team, but part of your new team?
No, I met my mans with Cavalli with Chase.
Oh, okay.
And we introduced it. We were working on a record together, and he was there.
So your relationship with Chase has just evolved.
Yeah. How I even I hit up Chase the end of 2018 and 2019, and he posted something up on his page, like selling beats or something like that, and then he pretty much put some nigga on blast about saying that he was gonna buy it and he never did it. And I was like, yo, he ain't buy for that, then I'm gonna buy that shit. He's like, I told him, I'll give you next day.
Yeah.
So I got a bet. So I gave him the next day, and he showed me the songs and beats, and I just picked the beat. But I kept that beat from February of 2019 all the way to May 2020. Damn. Till it was right to drop it.
Like, you just kept recreating songs on it?
No, I just kept the beat.
Oh, okay.
I wasn't ready for it. Like, it was too advanced for me at the time.
How'd you know it was time, though?
When I was ready.
It's just a feeling? That's what I'm saying. Just like, okay.
When I played it and like I had finally actually had words to it, I'm not gonna force. I don't force it. Mm-hmm. If it's not working, it ain't working. But you know, and I sit down in the studio, I'm just like, yo, yeah, this is it. All right, you know, I send out to the team. Everybody's like, no, they fuck with this. All right, we're a bet. We fucking with it. Nobody in my team's yes man. They'll tell me that shit's trash. Foreign told me some songs that are not hitting. like they're my team like is. They're mean.
Have you ever had a song that you were like, yes, this is the one, and they were
hell
like,
hell yeah,
nah.
I had a song that I thought it was the one. But they would tell me, like, you know, nah. And they saved my life going looking back to it. It's like, oh, word, that would've damaged my shit.
Damage? Nah, I can't say.
Damage. She's damaged.
All right, I don't know how that sounded out the tune, but.
Man, how did you figure out you could sing? Like, just one day you were out just singing and.
My mom, oh, sorry, mom. I'm throwing you out here. So like, yo, so like when I was seven, I was in music class, and like my music teacher would tell me, like, we would sing, like, you know, like little group, we were like 7 years old, those singing stuff.
Yeah.
And my teacher, I'm gonna give him this shout out, Mr. Ryan, you know, like,
shout out Ryan.
He told me, he called
you
my
remember
mom.
Your teacher's name, that's pretty wild.
Yeah, because he came actually from middle school. He went from elementary school to middle school. So it was like basically my whole damn life. So he called my mom after and told her that she was like, Nathaniel is, he's a really good at this music singing. I really think you should invest in him doing this. My mom was like, So I was like, she never told me this until I won a contest. And I'm like, what? She's like, yeah, like I didn't, you know, I got a call like years ago. I was like, man, I could have been on American Idol or something. I could have been
popping. Damn, man. That's rough. Moms didn't even want to hook you up.
No, because my mom lets me express how I want to be.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So like, I was, at that time, I was an artist. Like, really, I'm still an artist. But, like, a painter, I was drawing cartoons and stuff, like anime, stuff like that. And I was going to go to I was in, like, all the advanced art classes. I was going to go to an art school in high school.
Yeah.
But I just never did. I wanted to be normal. I wanted to have a social life. you know.
What led you to where you are today?
T-Man. Tyler, that's my brother, man. He got killed in a car accident in 2015 that made me really, you know, really. This is 5 years that have passed in, like, August. It really got real with all of us when we seen it. And, like, a whole that, like, it was such a sudden thing. I remember that day like it was yesterday. Like, it's something, like, I remember my man called me up. I was driving. I was going to go to the movies. And he called me and... I didn't believe, no one's gonna make some shit up like that about something like that. No one jokes shit like that. So all our closest friend or group friend just drove right there. Like, it was like, it was just an emotional day. It just, the whole thing happened. And after that, like, I just knew that after, like, music was a hobby. Like, it was fun. I was still in college. I was doing stuff like that. But then when that happened, it hit harder because that was really the definition of what, to me, what loyalty showed. Like, Tyler was, like, literally the most loyal person I ever met in my life. That's, like, I'm an only child, so, and I don't really got that much family. Like, it's really me, my mother, and my little cousin. But, like, so, like, when it comes to, like, brotherhood, my friends around me, they're my brothers. I don't roll with nobody that I know that if I'm rolling somebody, they wouldn't, like, take a bullet for me type shit. Like, that's, there's certain, like, I'll do some shit. Like, like, you feel me? So, like, when he went, I knew I owed him, like, I just owed him shit, like, just don't be no bum. Like, because he told me the last, like, because prior to that, it was 2 weeks before he called me, had a conversation, I went to his crib, and he was just like, he said, bro, you take music seriously, you know how far you could go? Type of stuff, like, yo, you really can make Recavic put to the map type stuff, you know? I was like, word, like, I told him, like, and I shook on it, I was like, yo, I'm gonna get you a Grammy. And then, you know, 2 weeks happened, that happened, and after that, I was like, all right, I got a mission, I have to get a Grammy. Like, I have to, I'm not just, fuck the nomination, I'm gonna get a Grammy. So then pretty much I linked up with Foreign, and like I needed a studio bad as shit, like really bad as like hell to get one. And he had a place, he opened his arms to bring like to start working there. His brothers was there, and you know, everybody was around us was like very older, so like they were being like real with me in the nicest way possible. Be like, this is trash. And one of them would tell me like, yo, this song, you singing the song, but I don't really feel you. Like, it's just, like, things like that that kind of, like, all right, manned me up a little bit to understand, like, all right, I'm a little ready for this. And then I started making beats there with Recavic on my friend. My first EP was off the strength of, like, we just lost Tyler. So, like, I wanted, like, that was kind of keeping us all together at the time. We would just always go to, you know, Foreign's house, just chill and just get stuff done. But then after that, like, it got when you're new to stuff like that and understand, like, you know, we're young, we're like 19, like 18 type stuff, just getting out of high school, and like a lot of egos. Like, I can't even blame I got like a lot of ego at that time because I was new on some stuff. So like, you know, things like that, it was a learning experience for that. I won a contest at the time, you know. It was all from in-house, so like we just record, everything we did was recording at his house. My man Max Blue, we did this tape together, all production. And then like I just, you know, I won the contest with this Hot 97 thing in 2016. It was hosted by Peter Rosenberg. I won it. And he put my music on the radio. And so that was like the first thing to show me like, oh, we can really get this done. And this is like, I don't got no money like that. So like, I got on the radio, like people would offer me money to get on the radio.
Wait, they'd offer you money to do what?
Before I won the contest to get on the radio and I got on the radio, people would offer me like, yeah, I'll give you money right now, but I'll throw your songs on the radio. I'm like, I'm not really feeling it. I got, almost money I got offered into my life, man. A lot. I know my worth. So I'm not just going to get into debt on some shit that I know I feel like is not really becoming of what could be.
Yeah,
it's not really like that.
So then what's your goal then? Is it to get signed to a label? Is your goal to get 10-12 as part of a label deal?
My goal is to make sure 10-12 is everywhere. NateTaylorr is everywhere. I'm in your Serato. I'm on your like your TV screens. I'm at the award shows. I'm working with your favorite artist, your favorite rapper. I want to get in the film. I want to make a cartoon show. Our 10-12 brand, like, I want it to be more than just an art. It's not just music. It's a production company. We make things happen. We don't.
You gotta get the cartoon going. We got the cartoon Sloppy Verse coming. We're building a cartoon too. Build a cartoon, the world's across.
We going collab, you know. Feel me? We got a Cartoon Network plug, by the way.
Yo, imagine like a whole Jersey, just like everyone started their own cartoon show. That shit would go crazy. No, like, forget Nickelodeon, all that stuff.
That can be done. Everything can be done. You just gotta execute it right.
Yeah.
You know, so I think bigger, because after, you know, what I drop next is gonna fuck y'all up. I cannot wait, because it's gonna be so like. It's gonna be so epic. I want to show you this. Like, I really am gonna show you this. It's gonna be so fire. But like, when it comes to Jersey artists, yo, I want to work with all of y'all.
Who do you want
to
work with?
In Jersey?
Yeah.
I want to work with 070 Shake. Mm-hmm. I want to work with Trey Bando. I want to work with.
His name comes up a lot too.
Who?
Trey Bando.
That nigga nice as shit, bro. He's so nice. I want to work with. I think, is he retired? I don't know if he's retired. Who served?
No, so he just dropped the project.
I heard some shit on Joe Budden's podcast or something. I don't know. I saw something.
He just did that song with Dougie F too.
I want to work with.
You go. You and Sue Surf would be interesting.
Who?
You and Sue Surf would be interesting.
Yeah, because like I can bring something else. So I always want to add to an artist. I never want to be like the outshine one. Like, but I'm gonna do my part. But you know, if I do my part and you're not up to par, it's not my fault.
Yeah.
But like, I always want to work. Cause I really, like, I can see it. Like, I see the vision for a lot of things. I would love to work with what's the face? I would love to work with. She's a writer. She's a songwriter. I think it's not. What's her name for? She wrote like hits. Yes. I don't want to mess up. I was out.
Nah, let's see this.
Something with an A. It's like,
nah, it's not an A. It's an N. I think it's an A.
But does she make music or she's just a songwriter?
She writes for everybody.
I think you and Justin Love would be dope too.
Justin Love is. I have people that know him and everything like that, but I haven't like never like fully met him.
No, I showed him your music a couple weeks ago.
How you feel about it?
He liked it.
Shout out to you, bro.
I showed him the Toss Me video.
He fucked with it?
Yeah.
Yo, let's work, bro. I'm about to sign your DM right now, bro.
I showed him.
That's fire. Y'all fuck with Justin Love.
See, people don't know. Like, behind the scenes, I do stuff, and when I connect with people, I show music.
He's real. Like, this man, bro, we met on some low key shit. Like, he around. I pulled up. Yeah. I don't know what we went like a part lot.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So like, he really cool as shit, man. Like, yeah, I like, yo, and he was like one of like the. Like, I think you're the first interview that happened for Life of Luxury this year.
Yeah, possibly. No. I think we did it before it came out, didn't we?
Yeah, we did the IG Live. Yeah. I'm saying you're the first one. Like, yo, for you, my man.
But yeah, nah, I was with him, and he was just asking about artists, and I showed him your music, so.
Yeah, like, I just...
I think you two would be dope.
Bro, I would love to work with him, man, too. I just can't, on the fly, I got to think, I'm like...
Yeah, it's always hard. Like, people ask me stuff, like, I'm like, I go blank.
Ish Williams, too. Mm. That's my man's. I want to get a lot of stuff done, man. For real. Like, I really just want to make sure that, like, that jersey, you know, fuck with me. But, if, like, what's going on right now is, like, everywhere else, you know. Jersey's mess with me, but it's just, like, I don't have enough, you know. I need a little more light on me.
That's you ever going to put a tape out where you produce the whole thing, too, since you said you make beats?
Oh, yeah, me and I would love to work. Once this border's open, me and Keen are going to get in the lab, and we're going to make a production of just me and him.
Hopefully those borders open eventually.
He can slide over here, but he don't want to go back and be in the 2 week.
Oh,
the
Canada could come here.
He can come back, but they're not like America. They're actually real about their laws.
America. Oh, this is gonna post next week. I was gonna say vote tomorrow, but we'll already know.
No, we won't.
Yeah, we will.
I don't think so. I think they're gonna wait a couple of days before we could tell.
Yeah, but this interview. What's today? Monday? No, Thursday.
It's Tuesday. Monday.
Today's Monday.
Yo, it's all right.
So this interview.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
Yo, okay, but that's because I shoot interviews on Mondays and Thursdays.
Yeah, no one's coming at you, bro. No one's saying. Monday, Tuesday.
So this interview.
You missed 2 days, bro.
This interview will be dropped. So the lecture is the 3rd, which is tomorrow. This interview will be dropped whatever next Monday.
Either way, man.
Did you vote yet? Are you just saying that? Because you could be saying, yeah, it would make sense next week. All right, cool. Everyone needs to vote.
Everybody got
to
vote.
Hopefully we get these results that
if
we
y'all
want.
Don't vote, like, you got to vote. Like, I really don't. Listen, man, I'm not, do what you makes best for you. That's all I'm going to say. Because there's people that are going to say, oh, I'm voting for so-and-so, I'm voting for so-and-so. In reality, they're not doing that. They're really going to vote for what's best for them. That's it. Like, really.
Is that tattoo new? I keep peeping it.
You know this?
Yeah.
This little thing? Yeah, it's like, new. You feel me? I'm going to see the camera and shit, you know. We different out here. Feel me? You know why I got it?
No, that's what I was going to ask. So it's two eyes.
It's two eyes. What do they look like to you?
It's a girl crying.
Girl eyes type shit, right? Because, you know.
But then it goes into a spade.
Yeah, but
so that could mean like an ace.
Yeah, that's my ace, my killer. But, when you see the eyes, like, it's a person's eyes. But obviously, women, I feel like women go through the most, in my opinion. So you can tell a story, you can look in someone's eyes and tell a story from them every single time. So, but when I shake people's hands now, though, like, I can see through your bullshit if you do some fuck shit to me. That's what I really why I got it. That's what it is.
But is it crying? Or is it just a line going down?
What do you think it is?
Crying.
It's crying.
Okay, I didn't know. Yeah. Was that the tattoo you got on Foreign's birthday? Because I know you guys were talking about getting tattoos.
Yeah, it doesn't. Yes. It was close to his birthday, but it wasn't on his birthday.
Happy birthday, belated.
Yeah, you feel me? Oh, by the way, my business partner / manager and my best friend is born on 10/12. And so is T-Man. Tyler, his birthday's on 10/12, but so it's deeper than rap. Like, this is not we just picked a random number. This is real shit, you know? I got 10/12 tatted on me, but not the logo version of it, but I got 10/12 tatted on me.
You gotta get the logo.
I know.
I got my logo. You gotta get your logo.
That's so fire. He's talking about tats. Yeah, if you can zoom in on that.
They know the shit. This is old now, man.
You can, we gotta go. Where you going? Cause it's kind of crisp on you, cuz.
I always get like two or three at a time.
Two or three at a time? Damn, all right. Well, my next one's gonna be a neck tattoo.
You said what?
My next one.
I want to get like I will get my whole face tatted up for real.
My mama said not to touch my face or she will never love me again like that, bro. Like,
I just feel like once I do that though, like.
You first of all, you got a face tat, bro?
Well, not like, I want to get like, I think it's dope when they got like the hairline tattoos, like the side.
You get a face
like,
tat, bro?
Like, eyebrows.
Bro, you get a face tat, bro? Yo, like, I'm not going to say like you in this, but you in this,
yo, you
bro.
In it.
Like,
once you get a face tattoo, that's it.
That's why I'm about
to. You better make 1,000% sure.
Like, honestly, people that got neck tattoos are still cool with it, but it's just like a face?
No, yeah, neck I think you get off. Behind the ear, you could get off.
I got one behind here too.
Yeah, but like, I feel like once you go right here.
Bro, you touch your face, bro, you real.
You're not dedicated yet. I'll say face
tattoo. I'm dedicated, but my face pretty. I don't know what y'all talking about. Like, I don't need to put nothing like on my face, but like if I did, like, just, you know, just reach out. Like I ain't doing that. I don't know what I would get on my face. But maybe I don't wanna set in the stone. I might get a face tattoo. Sorry, mama.
Going home and breaking your mother's heart. Like,
damn,
that's fucking with you. I'd be wondering what mom's be thinking, right? Like, damn, when there's kids come home.
She literally told me, like, well, actually, every tattoo was on me, and she said, nah, but I came home one time with this big-ass tattoo, and she just couldn't say anything after that. Like, I just came home with it.
But, yeah, anything else you want to talk about? Anything I missed? Anything you want to bring up?
My favorite animal is a turtle. Dead ass, bro? Sea Turtle, though. Oh, you mean, you were going to link up after this, bro.
Oh, I thought, like, I missed something. Like, that was like, wait, did the camera go off or something? Like,
yo, you just valid, right? Yo, if you don't like turtles, but you weird, bro. Like, dead ass, I got a tat right there. That's my first tat. No, this cap. But I'm saying that's my first tat on my arm that was right here. A little sea turtle, bro. And you know the reason why I got it? Because I was a little angry child. So, like, yo, I looked at it. I'm like, yo, what can I get on my body that if I look at it, I can't get mad at? A turtle. What the fuck? Who gets mad at turtles, bro? Like, I don't... You gotta be an evil mother.
Like your mom's name.
No. I have a... No, it's not like that. It's just I don't like having people tatted on me and they're alive.
Nah, I feel
like
that.
It's giving me superstitious. Like, I feel something's gonna happen to them.
Nah, I feel
that's
that.
Just me. Like, I got my, like, my granny on here. Her name's Gloria, but I put Glory because, like, I don't want to do that. I'm very superstitious with stuff like
nah,
that.
Nah, yeah, between, yeah, manifestation, a lot of stuff. You seem very spiritual. Oh, like,
yeah.
Energy.
Yeah, hell yeah. I believe in a lot of things, man. And people don't, you know, don't let someone tell you how to think, how to move. Be your own person. Obviously, look up information every single day because they're not going to tell you for you. You got to look that shit up. Shout out to Twitter and shout out to freaking Instagram and all that shit because they can't hold us down forever, bro. We're going to change this shit. We're really going
to
change
Instagram
this shit.
Do be trying to hold people down, though.
You see how they're doing the other extra stuff, right? But Facebook run the fucking world. So, like...
Yeah, Facebook, yeah.
Like, I just want people to understand, like, always search, always get information. Don't ever let somebody tell you that you can't do something because they just can't do shit for themselves at the end of the day. And the last thing I want to tell you is my favorite color is purple.
But you're wearing all red. You got a red hat, red hoodie.
Yo, why you do that? why you do that, bro?
I'm like that dickhead, like you say something. I'm like, oh, what about this?
Well,
nah, I just fucking with you. Purple. I like purple a lot, too. I can't
remember. Oh, damn, he caught me. I kind of
fucking... Purple's royalty.
King Sailor.
Boom, look at that. We brought it full circle. Is that the next tattoo?
Hell no.
King Taylor?
King Sailor sound like a tape. That's like a mixtape. You gave me an idea, too.
That shit will go hard.
Shout out, you gave me an idea.
I need executive credits.
You definitely get a cameo.
I need points on the board.
Yo, Kings. Ooh, that's fire. Nah, y'all ain't ready for that. Nah, you're not. Shit.
That should go crazy.
Honestly, yo, yeah, bro. Cut the tape, bro. We done out here now because I'm about to start going off. Yo, that sounds fire, bro.
Wait.
Because that idea for King Tail, you gave me like a whole like concept.
Wait, are we talking or are we cut
it? I don't know, but this is just.
Because we didn't even end it yet, so this is probably part of it.
Hey, bro, fuck it, yo. Y'all take my shit, man. I think of something better. Fuckers.
Taylor gang.
You know, I've gotten that so many times. Like, he thought I wanted to be part of Taylor gang. Nate Taylor is my name. Like, it's literally Nathaniel Taylor. Yeah, you feel me? Like, that's my name. Like, that's really my name. So I don't need to... Why would I do that? Like, I love Wiz and everything, but, like, why would I do that?
Would you do a song, Wiz?
Yeah.
Feel good heart?
Anything I go on is gonna be hard, bro. I don't know about y'all, but like, everything I do is gonna turn to gold. There's only like I wouldn't work with 6ix9ine, obviously.
I don't think he's working with anybody right now. I think he's done up.
Yo, that's crazy.
So if an artist from Jersey wants to work with you, because you said you are open, so how do they reach out to you? What's the best way for them to get in contact with you?
Slide in the DM or hit foreign, bro. That's it. Like, I'll work with y'all, man. We can get this shit going. Like, I just. You know, I really, there's nothing you really, reach out to me, bro. Like, what the fuck?
That's it?
Nah, I really want to work with a lot of people. It's just, I've only went this way I'm going because of nobody, you know.
The price went up this year, though. Way up. So they got to catch you before it goes up again.
They got to catch me. I don't want to work with nobody again.
Damn.
Like, nah, because, like, I really to a point, like, nah, I really, like, it's just, it's not even artists. Like, it's just everybody got so much ego, bro. That's all it is, man. I really want to work with mad artists. And I really want to work with mad artists, like, because it'll just brings the best out of the two. Like, I feed off other energies on songs. So, basically, I got to compete with myself every time I do a song. That's why I like working with Norman, because me and him comment each other a lot. Me and Mir did a dope, like, that one song we did was dope. Fee. But I really haven't, like, really collabed with a lot of artists. I like, reach out to producers most likely for my collaborations.
Yeah, you're big on that. I know it's like finding the right producers.
I try to find producers, and I don't really like going off names either because like people go off big names and think that's going to work for them. But in reality, it's like you got to make sure your sound matches what they got going on. Or it can bring it up or advance you. Like a lot of people get cut off and like kind of like caught up in like the wave and stuff. But if I can like buy a feature, like from somebody, I'll get Chef G.
So Chef G. So you would hop on a drill song?
He's drill?
Yeah.
You think he's really?
Chef G?
She's drill like that?
You
like,
said Chef G, right? Like Sleepy Hollow Chef G?
Yeah. It's like I don't think it's on like pop smoke drill like type shit. But it's
they have like a darker drill.
They have their own type of like drill, I guess, from Brooklyn type stuff. But like I work with them. I work with Shea Crew. I work with The Weeknd.
No, for real? You told me by next year. You're still on the clock. You told me that, I think. When do we do the IG Live? Like, April?
Me and him are going to have a song next year.
March?
It was a, no, April? It was
June?
It was
May?
It was June.
June?
Bro, I'm only going to work. When me and The Weeknd drop, don't be surprised. That's all I'm saying. XO12. Keep saying it. XO12.
XO12, Nate Taylor, two R's. How do I keep... I got to stop. I'm very, like...
What you mean?
I'm very, like, when I talk, like, very... Nate Taylor, two R's. Catch them. Where can catch you? All DSPs.
All DSPs. Nate Taylor. NateTaylorr. Two R's. And you'll see this man right there. And you'll honestly go get Life of Luxury. It's really deluxe. And go check out the whole catalog because I'm nice. I promise you. If you play me like around people, they're gonna like it too. Please, like just, hey, please just play it.
This is the Garden State Hip Hop Hour. I appreciate everybody that's tuned in. If you're watching this on YouTube right now, like, subscribe, comment, and stay tuned for the next one. Peace.